Hey, Lewis Turner here for Guitar and Tractor Magazine, back with another review. And in this one, I'm checking out an amp, and this amp is the Peavey Classic 20MH. So, as we can see, a small little head unit here, and perfectly compact, looks great, and hopefully, as you've already heard, it sounds pretty cool as well. So we're gonna go through some of the different features and see some different sounds we can get out of it. So this is an all tube 20 watt head, if you like. So powered by two EO84 power tubes and three 12AX7 ECC83 preamp tubes. It's a two channel amp, three band EQ. And at the start there, you heard it on the crunch channel that will go through. We'll set everything back to normal and check out the other features on it. So starting from left to right, we've got volume, the channel switch, pre and post controls, and the three band EQ of bass, middle and treble, and the reverb and a standby and on off power switch. So here's our clean channel. As you might expect from an all tube amp, you know, we're getting beautiful warm sounds from it. And then obviously I can change my EQ as I wish. So this bit was at the start. I might want to add a bit more bass to it. Etc. I might want a more cut-in sound. And then our reverb unit down here, so we can go all from a very dry tone all the way up to crazy reverb levels. Very musical reverb, very usable, which is great. You know, it gets very high, but it sounds beautiful, which is very good. Okay, onto our, so that's all very straightforward. And then we have our channel control here. So basically your drive channel, so if I press that in here. So this is the sound, it comes with a foot switch as well, actually, I should say, which is great, as quite often you have to buy the foot switches separately, which is never a good thing. So this is included. So this is where I had it set at the start. As a kind of a midway crunch. So our pre controls the level of gain we have. And then the post essentially gives us the volume of the second channel. So if I wanted to go for like a slightly just broken up sound. For those kind of crunchy rhythms, we can get that. If I wanted to go for a very saturated sound, let's see what happens if I take the pre right up. We'll be right back. So we have plenty of gain available to us as well, which is great. So we can see a very versatile amp and a very great sounding amp. A couple of other cool features on it. So it's got, at the back, we've got an effects loop, and there's a switch as well where we can change the output. So it's a 20 watt amp. But what we find with tube amps essentially is that if we want to get that really cool sound, you have to kind of push them a little bit. So that kind of little broken up sound, we need to get the volume above halfway. And a 20 watt amp is actually pretty loud when it comes to tube amps. So if you're trying to record in your house or whatever late at night, and you want to get that authentic sound, then having a 20 watt amp turned right up is probably going to drive the neighbors nuts. So the switch we got on the back can change between 25 or 1 watt without losing, and these are more and more popular now on small amps, without losing any of that gain quality, without losing any of the power. So we've been on a 20 watt setting. If I change it, so this is 5 watts. So I keep it on the crunch channel, and you hear I've lost some volume, obviously, but you haven't lost any power. And I can get all the way down to 1 watt, which gives me a very quiet amp. But hopefully you're still here and it's still coming through at your end, that we've still got the balls there, if you like. So you can record at very, very low volumes and still have the crunch. And the same applies to my clean channel. I still get all the warmth. That I require on all three settings. The 5 and then back up to 20, you'll hear the... So that's a really, really cool feature, and they become more and more popular on small amps like this. So the great thing is you can record at low volumes. 20 watts is really powerful for most situations you're going to come across, whether playing for fun or playing, for audiences. This is the right size kind of amp to start getting those broken up tones from without really ruining your ears. So that's really cool. Other things in the back, we can plug into different size speakers, so 8 ohm, 16, etc, etc. So it's really everything you could need in a portable little size amp that's not ridiculously heavy as well. So on the start there, we heard the kind of crunch channel. I finish off with a little bit of clean noodling. The setting I might have normally. And turn the reverb up a little bit. So here's my here's the clean channel. So a top little versatile amp there. Looks great, really, really sounds good. And we've got loads of different sounds we can play around with without having a million and one controls, all straightforward to use, very intuitive, very dynamic as well, being all tubes. So there we have it. So that's been the Peavey Classic 20MH. If you're looking for a nice portable small tube head and you're fed up with carrying around a big 100 watt jobbies, then this could well be the amp for you. Pristine cleans, nice crunch all the way up to fairly decent saturated lead sounds. You could stick a couple of your favourite stomp boxes in front of it and, you know, run some delays through the effects loop and you'll be well away. Top little amp, highly recommend you check one out. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.